YEEHAW.com/wreckingroom Thursday, August 26th at 8 p.m. Central.
Now back to the Volume.com studio in Nashville, Tennessee. You're listening to Lightning 100.
Yes, indeed. Welcome back into the Volume.com studio. We are live here on Lightning 100 and streaming live at Volume.com/Lightning100. The gang's all here. Daniel Donato, welcome. Howdy. To have you here.
Great to be had.
And you brought the band with you. We've got, Nick, Will, and Kirby, correct?
That's right.
Or Billy.
Or Billy. Okay. Well, I'm asking you.
It don't matter.
Okay.
I just show up.
All right. It sounded great during sound check, so very excited for the whole world to be able to listen in. Again, if you're listening on the radio and have access, volume.com/lightning100, you can actually see the guys here in studio with us. But great to have you here, Daniel. The new album, well, relatively new album, Young Man's Country, available now. We're excited about the show coming up tomorrow night at Brooklyn Bowl.
Yeah.
Nashville, Cordova's and the Cowpokes on that bill as well.
Yeah.
That's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
For those that maybe are tuning in that are not familiar with your backstory, which a lot of artists that we have here in the studio are not from Nashville.
Mm.
But you actually were born in, I know you were raised here. Were you
raised
born
here?
Raised here,
yeah.
Okay. But you've been here for quite some time, correct?
Yeah, it seems like forever now. Yeah,
so
a lot of change here in the city.
Definitely, and actually got your start down, as some folks have here in Music City, just playing down on Broadway in front of the arenas and stuff, and actually made your way into Roberts. So again, for those that are not familiar with your backstory, can you give them just like the Cliff Notes version of how you started playing? Because, I mean, how old are you?
26.
26.
I was really trying to skateboard, and I was just really bad.
I can relate to that.
He was just not
good.
A few years farther back, but yeah, definitely.
We had this Guitar Hero at my house, and so before we go skateboarding after school, it would be like, let's go play Guitar Hero. I kind of just had this affinity for the music. And then I just fell in love with playing guitar, and it was this thing that it just really pulled me in. It's never stopped.
Yeah.
And like a couple years into that, my dad was like, why don't you go try, throw your guitar case open down on Broadway and busk for tips. We tried that. And I got invited to play on stage, and like that was a revelatory moment in my life. And then we went down the next day, and then we stumbled into Robert's Western World, which is like the home of traditional country music.
Oh, yeah.
It's right by the Ryman. It's like, it's a really cosmic building.
Yep.
And I snuck in there by accident. I wasn't supposed to be in there at that time. And I saw the Don Kelly band playing, and it was like this, for anyone who doesn't know, it's like the most legendary Nashville band that never played anywhere outside of Nashville. Never toured. Played five nights a week for over 30 years and missed 5 weeks total. And I went and saw this band every week for like 3 years, and I gave them my card. I was like, I want to play in this band so bad. Like there was something in that band that I needed to learn and discover.
Yeah.
Played in the band. We would play 4 hours a night. I played almost 500 shows with them. I stopped playing with that band. I went on tour with other bands. And then this concept of cosmic country started coming around in my mind and brewing. And so what we have here is cosmic country.
Yes.
As far as I'm concerned, in the most realized form. And so, a lot of artists will come in and they'll try to like kind of negotiate with the music and bring it down to an acoustic level. But it's like, I want to try to bring the live experience as close as we can to the listener here.
Yeah.
So that's why we have Nick, Will, and Billy.
All right.
With us today.
All right. Well, yeah, as I mentioned, we were setting up. You guys did a little line check, and it sounds fantastic.
Thank
so
you.
Absolutely.
ready for the world to hear it. So you're going to play a couple for us. You're going to play Why You've Been So Long.
Why You've Been Gone So Long. Yeah.
And Justice. Which one do you want to lead off with?
We'll start off with Why You've Been Gone So Long, which is actually from a new record we're putting out here pretty soon called Cosmic Country Western Songs.
Awesome.
Which we were going to announce tomorrow, and my management might be mad about that, but I just announced it right now.
And more breaking news live right here on Lightning in the Morning. But yes, here live in the Volume.com studio, we've got Daniel Donato and Cosmic Country.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Let's do it.
Two. One, two. Listen to that thunder, can you hear that?
pictures in my head. Or kill the fifth of Thunderbird and try to write a sad, sad song. But tell me, baby, why have I gone so long? Tell me, baby, why have I gone so long, even gone so long now? Tell me, baby, why have I gone so long? The wolf's scratching at my door. My door, Lord, can you hear that lonesome wind moan? And tell me, baby, why have I gone so long? And tell me, baby, why have I gone so long?
Very nicely done, Daniel Donato. Why you been gone so long?
Yeah.
I'm surprised the studio could handle all that. To be completely honest, the windows are still intact, and I'm very impressed with their integrity.
We'll set the over under about 3 minutes until we hear from our neighbors downstairs saying, "Hey, it sounds great down here, guys."
Cool. Yeah.
Yes, indeed. Daniel Donato joining us here in the Volume.com studio. And again, I know we've got some folks. If you're not aware, Volume.com/Lightning100. You can actually see what's happening here in the studio. But yeah, sounding great, guys. So you mentioned been working on the new record.
Yeah.
Which is, how far out are we from the release of the new stuff?
So, like, last week of September is what we're going for.
Okay, so about a month out.
About a month out, and that whole record was inspired by not being able to tour last year and us actually going back to Roberts and playing there sometimes for no one, right when they were starting their phases of opening again. And
right.
It was this really, you know, interesting time of Nashville, like, finding its identity down on Broadway again, especially that cultural hub of Roberts. Like, it means so much to the city. So there are some days we're playing in there and there's freaking seven people after 4 hours.
Right.
And so we're revisiting these old honky-tonk and, you know, country songs and putting this twist on them where we jam them, we take them out, and we bring a new life and energy to them, and try to outfit them for, you know, where we are today in music, especially live music.
Sure.
And so that's what this whole record is. It's like these old songs of yesterday that still have legs today, except they're just, like, dressed cooler.
Yeah. Right?
Cool sunglasses now.
Yeah, like Ray-Bans and, like, Jordan 1s.
Right, yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah. They have a blue check on Instagram.
Yes, indeed. So I definitely can hear that influference of, you know, the picking a little bit, that kind of get picking you'll hear when you head out to Roberts. And to your point, that's anytime, you know, I have family or friends that come into town, it's like, okay, where do we go for honky? It's like, well, you know, a lot of folks will throw out different ones. It's like, no, it's Roberts. That's where you go. That is the spot. But kind of going forward, and you mentioned Guitar Hero, which I had a lot of fun with that. And I can do pretty well at Guitar Hero when there's, you know, different colored buttons. Can't pick like you can, Daniel. My goodness. I also you got into the Grateful Dead a little bit. And that has had a little bit of an influence on you, right? That's kind of where the cosmic country came from.
I think so, man.
Yeah?
I'm still learning what cosmic country is. It feels like it found me in some way. But there's this time I was playing. I had this amazing history teacher, Mr. Ragland, and he was like a three-piece suit at school at 6:30 a.m. You know, an hour before everyone else, kind of a guy. And he came and saw me play at Roberts on one Wednesday, which was like the first night of the week we play. We play Wednesday through Sunday.
Okay.
And he came in and through the back door, and I had no idea he was there. And I guess he watched me for like the whole night. And we were playing some country songs that the Dead play. They play, like, you know, Johnny Cash songs and Marty Robbins songs and Merle Haggard songs because of Bob Weir loving country music.
Sure.
And so the next day in class, in the middle of class, and I was a straight A student, like, I took school very seriously.
And again, you should out there in Radio Land, kids, take school seriously. Yes.
He in the middle of class, it was something about, like, the Gettysburg Address. And he just, like, that reminds me, Donato, see me after class. He just called me out for no reason. And then just went back to his lecture. And so I go up to his desk, and he has these binders. And for everyone who can't see, the binders were probably like, I don't even know, man. What is that, 9-10 inches high?
At least a foot high, right?
At least let's say that. And it's just full of CDs. And he goes, he's looking me dead in the eye. And it was a very serious moment. He goes, I need you to listen to these and never bring them back to me again. And it was his entire Grateful Dead CD collection.
Mr. Wow. Raglan, you said?
Mr. Raglan.
He's a cool teacher.
He
right?
was cool. So I kept these CDs in my car. You know, I never had a girlfriend in high school because I was like always practicing or playing. So like where a girlfriend would have been, I just had like all these like...
a stack of Grateful Dead CDs.
Yeah, just like, so that just changed my life really forever.
Yeah.
That moment. And it was really... beautiful. That's the power of sharing music, I think.
Okay, follow up question real quick, because you said you like mid lecture, he just stopped, called you out, said, I want to see you after class.
Yeah.
What were you thinking the rest of the class? Just like, uh-oh.
Well, I'm a people pleaser. You know, as most extroverted, you know, people are who entertain people. We want to,
okay,
you know, we want to make sure that everyone around us is good and happy, you know? So
here,
I
here.
Think I was like, oh no, maybe I did something wrong.
That's what, yeah, you always think that, right? When I want to see you after class. You're just like, oh boy, okay.
It's very rarely something good, like a stack of Grateful Dead CDs.
Right, exactly.
And,
yeah, it's very rarely a gift.
An instruction to don't bring them back.
That was the thing, exactly. Too, is like the, I feel like the most powerful thing you can do for somebody is encourage them to dive headfirst into whatever their interest is.
Sure.
You know, and so that allowed me to put in the first CD, and nobody was like, bro, you got to listen to Dick's Pick 17, or like, there was no one like telling me what to do. I just got to experience this really wealth of music with no perception being forced in my mind.
Do the deep dive on your own, right? That's the best way to do it. Yes,
yeah.
Indeed. Very cool. We've got Daniel Donato here in the volume.com studio. Again, volume.com/lightning100 if you want to watch the boys play this next tune. So you're going to play Justice for us? You want to set this up? Tell us a little bit about how it kind of came about? Or
yeah, this was like, I was in with my girlfriend at the time, and I really loved her, and we ended up breaking up, and this song came out of that. So this, I think this song's a great example of what Cosmic Country can be, where it's like, it's a country song up front, and then when you come see us live, we really bring it somewhere that is not here, and then we bring it back to here.
That's wonderful, man. Music that can take you somewhere, there's nothing like it. So we're going to get a live sampling of that. Daniel Donato live here on Lightning 100 in the volume.com studio with Justice.
Thank you. All right. One, two, three, four.
Build a bed, a home out of the snow, or just leave it to the wind to blow. Well, ain't no other way to lay it down. Girl, the way I feel right now, it's like we have to leave this town. Cause I'm tired of hanging around. Well, there ain't no justice, I said justice, no discussion. We don't rush into this head on while you're keeping little secrets. You're my weakness, girl, I'm guilty, it's the truth. But ain't no justice without you. Justice, no discussion. We don't rush into this head on while you're keeping little secret. You're my weakness, girl, I'm guilty, it's the truth. Ain't no justice without you.
just there's no discussion. We don't rush into this. Head on while you're keeping little secrets. You're my weakness, girl, I'm guilty, it's the truth.
Yes. Called Justice. Daniel Donato with us in the volume.com studio. Again, still surprised our windows are intact. Like, I don't get it.
I think there might have been a rattle in there for a second.
Little,
thank
you
all for taking letting that happen. You know, it's like that's part of the vision, really, is to always have a band that knows where we're going and how to communicate together. So
absolutely fantastic.
Sounding absolutely great. What you play with so much feel and kind of different styles. And I know you were mentioning, you know, there's, to me, I never am a fan of, okay, what style of music are you? Are you a particular genre? Are you this? Are you that? You are Daniel Donato and you play great music. But what, as far as your influence goes, who were some of your influences as far, was it like the guitarist from the artists that, you know, were on Guitar Hero when you first started?
At first, I had, you know, your standard, like, archetypal fantasies of guitar, like Jimi Hendrix and Jimmy Page and Eric Clapton. And
sure.
I really was studious on those players. But the thing that really started sparking my imagination and creating a vision for me were a lot of the local players I was playing with down on Broadway that no one knows.
Right.
That played with, you know, Garth Brooks and played with Merle Haggard and, you know,
just some of the session cats and touring players.
Yeah.
It's just like you have no idea. You could be standing next to one in a Kroger.
They're
it's
wearing like New Balance shoes and like Levi 501s. And they literally have like a Bluetooth in their left ear. They're like not cool. When they go to a hotel, it's like in better shape than when they started there.
Right.
It's like nothing cool. It's like no Keith Moon style. Like, and those were some of my favorite players that no one knows. And they would just play, you know, these insane lines and I would go and sit in with them and they would show me. It's like, you know, well, you play A, but it's like you can play these cool. And it was like, who thinks like that aside from someone who is, has to make a living in Nashville.
Right.
So those are some of my players that I love. And then Jerry Garcia still changes my life all the time. And Jerry Reed, players like that. I love John Mayer. I don't care what anyone says about him. He was great.
You know what? I'm going to cue up some John Mayer. That's how we'll wrap things up here in just a minute. But because he's actually coming. You know, he's coming to Bridgestone Arena in April of next year, so you can make plans to be free on that day if you can.
I'll be there. Yeah.
I want to make, you know, set the record straight. When you did that little thing, you said you can play this. No, I can say that about you.
Oh.
I can't play that.
Also, not a chance.
Not many can, but Daniel, you definitely can, man. It's just sounding absolutely great. Looking forward to, we only have to wait for another month for the new record.
Yeah.
So that's more good news. You don't even have to wait that long to hear these guys perform once again. It's going to be tomorrow night out of Brooklyn Bowl, Nashville. Doors are at 6. Show starts at 7. We've got the Cowpokes and Cordovas opening up for Daniel Donato, the Cosmic Country and Western Songs happening tomorrow. Brooklyn Bowl, there are tickets available. Get them while they last. BrooklynBowl.com/Nashville. And you want to give a shout out to anybody that might be watching, might be listening, that you want to say hello to before we wrap things up?
I'd like to thank the universe.
Hear, hear.
All right.
Yeah. Everybody.
For all the inspiration and all the direction and all the challenges and bringing players in my life that inspired me. And
there you go. It's all encompassing.
It doesn't get much more cosmic than that.
That's right. That's right. So Daniel, Nick, Will, and Kirby, thank you all so much for joining us this morning. Great to have you here
in
the studio.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Absolutely. We look forward to doing it again real soon.
Likewise.
And we'll see you tomorrow night out at Brooklyn Bowl, Nashville. Get those tickets before they are gone. And by request, it's John Mayer and Last Train Home on Lightning 100.
Yeah.